Hi everybody. So I got the data for the sales in June via the MLS. So let's look at what sold in McCormick Ranch in June 2013. It's pretty cool. Here's what you'll see. You can at the top, let me give you a little tour here. You can do the list and you can get some information on each one, which I especially selected each of these categories. And if you want details on each of the homes, here we go. Hit detail. And under details are subcategories, including, and this time I included the tax information. And then the photos, of course, and the map that we started at. So let's look at, I selected a three homes just for fun to look at. You can go through and my up here you can select homes and put them in like a little subdivision, which is nice if you're reviewing them, like I'm doing here. So let's look at Lipizzan. So Lipizzan, of course, is beautiful. Thought this was a really nice home. Love that skyline. Nice floors, new kitchen. I love the Saltillo floors. Very well done. Love that yard. Spectacularly large, which is typically why people love the neighborhood. Here's another one. Santa Fe was one of the is a really interesting one because when the prices fell during the bust, Santa Fe was like one of the last neighborhoods to fall. The prices just hung in there. I remember I was looking for a client. They were hanging in at 500. The cheapest you could find was like 500. And then it was 490. You just couldn't find anything. But when they did fall, they caught up with the rest of the market. So they were one of the last to fall, but when they did, they caught up big time. So this one has flooring's nice. There we go. Totally redone kitchen. Very nice kitchen. Santa Fe, and of course these are what would I call them? Patio homes, not really. Townhouse, like a single level townhouse, essentially. And this is the least expensive home sold in McCormick Ranch in June. A single family home. And that's a pretty original kitchen, very original kitchen. So you see those, so that you get an idea. Let's go back to the list up here, and that went for 170 a square foot. So that gives you an idea that around 170 a square foot for something that's completely original, and it was just 2 years ago that 170 a square foot was above the average list price. Now it's sort of the bottom, or at least it was in June. So let's go back and look at the other one, which was these are townhouses, condos, and patio homes. Let's look at the most expensive ones. So typically, as is common, the most expensive one is in Colonia Encantada, right there. There's two of them that sold in there. And then the other most expensive place for non-single family homes in McCormick Ranch is La Paloma right there. So there's someone in Lakeview that's guard gated. They're both guard gated communities, both beautiful. For a long time, Colonial Encantada, like where this home is, oftentimes, like this month, was the most expensive. Well, in fact, oftentimes it was the most expensive home, not just the most expensive, not single family home sold. It's a beautiful little community. It's right across from Paradise Valley. Very nice. Oh, some homes, like this one's on the golf course. Very, that's a good deal. Oh, except this one I think was on the street. Was right on that it's gonna get a lot of traffic. Yeah, this one was on. Is that it'd be better if it was one unit in. Here's the other one. This is in Las Palomas. And here that's the one with the guarded gate. Some of these homes along the lake are spectacular. But anyway, this one is, I'm not sure this is on the lake. Updated flooring. Ooh, nice. Looks like those cabinets are original. Can that be? That's not. That's very nice. Very, very nice. Beautiful kitchen. That's kind of original, those baths. Let's see the patio. Okay, nice. Beautiful patio. Okay, let's go back. Here's the other one in Colonia Encantada. Don't think this one's on the golf course. Oh, that's pretty original. It's up to, it's, I don't know. That is, this could be the original cabinets. They got updated appliances, updated flooring, updated lighting. A lot of it's updated, but not the cabinets. Oh, I don't think those are updated. That went for 515. What was the square footage? Price per square foot on that was a one. Oh yeah, cool. 178. It's a fine price per square foot. Let's look at the other one. This one is. No. Okay, that was in Las Palomas. Okay, this one's in Las Palomas. There we go. Yeah, and this last one was back into Colonia Encantada. There we go. Pretty original. Whoa, very original there. Whoa, that is super original. And it went for 213 a square. Okay, anyway, that gives you an idea of what's going on. If you have any other questions about McCormick Ranch Homes, give me a call. I can research it for you. You need more information if you're wanting to sell. I have another video I did earlier today talking about where the market is headed in McCormick Ranch. So check that out. That would be on my website, McCormickRanchRealEstateHomes.com. I also have a private Google Plus community if you're on Google Plus, where I have additional information on. In fact, you can look at the information I'm showing right now. It expires after a month, but nevertheless, you can look at the details on any of the homes that sold in June via the MLS and McCormick Ranch. So that, but you got to subscribe to the private community. So that's for homeowners in McCormick Ranch. So if you like this video, please share it. If you're watching this on YouTube, you can subscribe to the channel. If you're on the website, I'd appreciate it if you, give it a one plus or like it or favorite it or bookmark it so you can come back to it. Because I'm starting to put in more information on the sales per month, and it's a lot of fun. And of course, if you're looking to buy or sell a McCormick Ranch, I can send you information so you can see what's happening to prices and what's available. Cool. So I'm starting to ramble again, so I'm going to get off. So thanks for listening. Yeah, really. Thanks. I appreciate you listening. Take care.